Ymir. Everything has a beginning, and in the case of Norse mythology, Ymir was clearly in focus as the first giant. He was created when the biomes of Muspel and Niflheim met together with the cow, Odd Humbla, whose milk he drank to live forever. From his sweat and feet he gave birth to three children before he was finally killed by Odin, they and Vili, and formed into the earth. In his blood drowned all other Jotun except Bergelmir and his wife, who escaped and gave birth to more Jotun. The Fate-Spinning Norns. Fate in the future also played an important role in Norse mythology. No wonder, since it was only thanks to prophecies that people waited for Ragnarok to befall the world. Accordingly, there was also a small group of ladies who dealt with it, the Norns. The Norns were three daughters who were descended from either the dwarves, the giants, or the gods. It is not entirely clear. Their names were Skald, Erd, and Verdandi. Verdandi stood for the present and the becoming, Erd for destiny and the past, and Skald for the future and what should be, the necessary. They probably lived at the roots of Yggdrasil at the Erd Spring, the source of destiny, and there they not only took care of the swans on the spring and the roots of the great ash tree, but also decided on the lifespan of every living creature. Often, word appears in connection with these names. However, one is uncertain from various sources whether this is another name of Erd, the three Norns in their entirety, or perhaps even their mother. The Valkyries. While Freya accommodates a part of the fallen heroes in Volkwang, as already mentioned, the Valkyries take care of the other half and bring them to the holy halls of Valhalla, over which Odin rules. The Valkyries are either minor deities or female spirit beings from the Allfather's retinue and are also called shield or battle maidens. They decided which heroes fell on the battlefield and which entered the sacred halls, and they may have been closely associated with the Norns. Their number varies in the tales from 3 to as many as 27. In some cases, they are said to have been able to transform themselves into wolves or ravens. In one tale, it is even reported that 3 of them flew down to earth and laid down their wings to bathe. Shortly thereafter, however, their wings were stolen by 3 brothers, and they kept the Valkyries as their wives for a full 9 years.